What's up everybody, this is Danny, and today I'm really excited to unbox the brand new OnePlus 6T. It came in this dope package sent over a little early in this white box, and there are a lot of goodies in here like some cases and the OnePlus USB-C bullets, but of course let's focus on the OnePlus 6T itself. The packaging does look a little different this year. Instead of a white box, it's more of a stone or a marble color, which looks pretty classy in my opinion. And it also has this new red tab here addressing the community of OnePlus users, which is really nice. And we'll take that off and let's go ahead and get into the box. There is the 6T right there. The first thing you'll see is the fingerprint logo, since there's an in-display fingerprint reader on board, and it says it works through their own screen protector or official partner protector. So that's pretty interesting. I have the matte black model here. There's also a mirror black model, but there's going to be no other colors at launch. You know how OnePlus does, they're gonna kill it with some custom colors later on. There's a packet here full of stuff, but we're gonna put that to the side. And right below that is a letter from the CEO that you'll have to peel back, which I think is a nice personal touch, so you can pause it and take a look at it if you want to. I totally butchered it and ripped it while I was opening it. Sorry, Pete. You also get the USB Type-C cord that is in the white and red color scheme, which I really love, and that amazing dash charger, which is so fast at charging. This one comes in at 5 volts and 4 amps, so you can expect some incredible fast charging from this brick. Let's go back to that packet. When you open it up, you'll see a clear case that's included. This is more of a dark smoke color, which I really like, and I wish more manufacturers would include cases with their phones. You get paperwork, quick start guides, more bathroom reading, and there's also a new set of clever OnePlus stickers here, which are really fun. These are a little bit different, I think, than the ones that were included before, so can't wait to see where these end up. So let's just do it like this. Why don't we talk about the 5 new features that are on the OnePlus 6T, and then maybe compare it a little bit to the OnePlus 6. The first thing I want to talk about are some of the design changes. I feel like they're very similar in the hand. They look pretty much identical. The first thing you're going to notice is that there's no headphone jack on the bottom, so there's going to be a lot of people angry about that, but they do give you a USB-C to 3.5 millimeter dongle in the box, and that's included, so that's pretty nice. Most manufacturers don't do that anymore, right, Apple? On day-to-day usage, the main differentiating factor here is the fingerprint scanner. So on the OnePlus 6, you have the fingerprint scanner on the back, but on the OnePlus 6T, you have a fingerprint scanner in the display. The setup process is a little bit longer than most other fingerprint scanners. It will make you register your fingerprint a lot, and also it'll make you do the edge detection. But I've been using this for about 48 hours, and I'm finding it to be pretty quick. As long as you put it right there where the fingerprint logo is, it's opening up pretty quick for me. So I'm a big fan of the in-display fingerprint scanner. You do have to put a little bit of pressure on it, and I find that it works a little bit better, but I find it to be really reliable. So hopefully this makes it to all of the phones in 2019, but this is great that this is in here, especially for this price. Just like on the OnePlus 6, you do have face unlock. It is just unreal fast. The second big change is the display. You get a 6.41 inch display, which is a little bit bigger, but the biggest thing for me is this new teardrop notch. I feel like it looks a lot better. It's so much cleaner. The screen to body ratio looks so much better with that teardrop notch. So let me know what you think, where the OnePlus 6 does have a little bit bigger of a notch, even though it wasn't obnoxious anyway, the OnePlus 6, but this one looks so much better to me. So let me know what you guys think. You really can't go wrong either way. They're both AMOLED, they're both bright, they're both vibrant. I mean, they're both 1080p in resolution. So these are some of the best displays in the business. I love them, so I don't think you can go wrong with either. The third major improvement is the battery. The OnePlus 6T has a 3700 milliamp hour battery, while the OnePlus 6 has a 3300 milliamp hour battery. So 400 milliamp hours should make a significant difference from day-to-day use. So once I use it a little bit more, I'll be able to let you know, but just on preliminary battery alone, this thing has been lasting me an entire day with no issues at all. So I am glad that there is expanded battery on this. So that might be one of the reasons why you might want to upgrade. The fourth thing is baseline configuration and pricing. I think the best deal here is $549, which is insane in this sea of $1,000 phones. For that price, you will get Snapdragon 845, you'll get 6 gigabytes of RAM and 128 gigabytes of internal storage. This could be maybe one of the best deals in smartphones right now. If you want to bump yourself up to 8 gigabytes of RAM, you can do that for $579. Or if you want 256 gigabytes of internal storage, that'll be $629. But for that price range, it is killer for all the specs and everything that you get in this phone. Yeah, I realize it's not a huge difference from the OnePlus 6 because the OnePlus 6 was already good at that price range. But this baseline configuration model, I think is gonna be an absolute killer this year. The fifth thing is carrier support. T-Mobile is gonna carry this phone in the United States, which is a big deal to me. I know people that don't live in the United States, I know, not a big deal, but people are gonna be able to walk into the store, they're gonna be able to see this in-display fingerprint scanner, this big screen to body ratio, big battery, flagship specs, for almost half the price of what they can get a flagship phone for. So I think this is gonna be good for both companies. T-Mobile is going to carry the 128 gigabytes of internal storage and 8 gigabytes of RAM version, which is that nice middle spec anyway. So you're gonna be able to go in. They even have a trade-in program where you can get $300 off this thing, which is insane. And I think it's like 11 bucks a month or something like that. I mean, the specific numbers I'll leave down there, or I'll leave a link down below for you. But I think this is gonna be the most affordable way to pick yourself up a OnePlus 6T if you live in the US. There are a few things missing from the 6T that I was really hoping to see, especially wireless charging because they use glass backs. I know that price has to be cut down, but it's one of the most convenient things now, and it's almost on all flagship devices. So I hope to see that on the next OnePlus, and also an official IP rating. It would have been nice, even IP67 or even IP68, even though that these phones are well sealed and they are kind of secretly waterproof, I would just like to see an official IP rating on the next one. So I want to know from you guys, the OnePlus 6T is here, but if you already own a OnePlus 6, is there enough new features in the OnePlus 6T to make you want to upgrade? Or if you don't own a OnePlus at all right now, does T-Mobile carrying this phone make you want to trade in your existing phone to get this phone for cheap? I really want to know. And also, the camera systems seem to be the same from both of these, but there are a few new software features like improved HDR and also a night mode. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you those samples right now. So stay tuned for a lot more 4K 60 cinematic, tons of other reviews, comparisons. I will see you in the next one. Let me know what you think of the camera quality.